paano siya magiging unstable if every time you make money, you put it back in the business, yeah. Eh. So kahit magkaroon ng recession 7 years down the line because you prepared for the first 5 years, okay kayo. And I keep saying this, 5 years of simplicity, hustling, working hard can lead to a lifetime of prosperity. Eh. Yeah. Kasi yung problema ng ibang nagbi-business is when they make the money, they want to buy the Land Cruiser kagad eh. They want to buy this big house eh. Why not baliktarin mo? When you make a lot of money, put it back in the business, invest it. Yeah. So when it starts becoming massive, dun ka mag-enjoy. Hi guys, so I'm still here in Qatar. This is part of our Ask Marvin session. Now, we have another kababayan here who's been based in Qatar for quite some time, who's investing in stocks and real estate, but he'd ask me specific questions that, ano nito, same. The goal is that I hope whatever he's asking, some of you can relate to his question so that it helps you. Because the end of all of this is to give you as much value as possible so that wherever you are in the world, even if you're an overseas Filipino or you are living in the Philippines, you get to make your money work hard for you and you be financially free. So I'd like to introduce you to Harris Acido. Yes. Hi. So this is our first vid. This is my first video with him. We're gonna do another one. We're gonna talk about his life. Naman, paano siya yumaman ng sobra dito sa Qatar. Oh, anyways, what's your question?
My first question, Coach Marvin, is that how can you convince your partner to invest if you have a different mindset?
How can you
convince your partner?
So kasal na kayo, hindi pa kayo kasal, kakasal pa lang kayo.
Pwedeng example yung hindi pa kasal, tsaka yung kasal na. Pero kami, in my situation,
okay.
I'm married already.
Okay, pag hindi pa kasal, baka mamaya might be better to find someone else. Joke lang. Hindi, kasi you have to remember this. Madami na marriages, nagfe-fail kasi nag-aaway sila sa pere. Madaming ganun eh. So dapat kung boyfriend-girlfriend pa lang kayo, at least sa start pa lang, you at least know already kung pareho kayo ng values sa pera. For example, madami nag-aaway kasi bakit dito kailangan natin magpadala sa parents mo, dito wala tayong papadala sa parents ko, or bakit mas malaki pinapadala natin dito hindi masyado, or yung isa mahilig mag-shopping, isa mahilig mag-ipon. So at least you need to know that sa start pa lang. So suggestion ko, prevention is better than cure. Kung hindi pa kayo married, find someone who has the same mindset as you, or at least pag-usapan nyo na earlier on. Kung kasal na kayo, edi you have to work it out. Kailangan nyo pag-usapan, kailangan din ma-realize nung whoever your partner is that it's important, it's vital na they have to realize that dadating yung point in time na hindi na sila magiging malakas na magtatrabaho forever, that habang bata sila, habang malakas sila, they need to have the ability to save as much as they can, na habang bata sila, yung alam mo yun, yung pag-save nila ng pera. Mahirap to stairs, ha? Yung pag-save nila ng pera, it will help them later pag matanda na sila. Kasi that's what I always say, eh. When you're younger, you save as much as you can because your future self will thank you for it. So, yung iniisip nung kung sino man yun is that it's also them saving and preparing for their own future as well. So, the best way to do it is to talk about it. And then, lalabas naman sa numbers, eh. Kaya nga, that's why ako, I'm a numbers guy because makikita mo sa numbers eh, that time always wins eh, that when you set aside money to invest early on and hindi mo inubos lahat ng pera mo habang bata ka pa, you will win. So the best way to say it is you create a budget, meron pang enjoy for the present, pero meron din pang pundar for the future.
That's good.
Pero hindi mo na problema kasi pareho kayong financially.
No.
Hindi lang may financial mindset, financially free pa guys. So this is a story of how Filipinos outside the Philippines make it in life. Oh, next.
No, idol ko na si Coach Marvin.
Then. Okay, next.
Second question ko kay Coach is, when is the best time to leave your job? What percentage of a good cash flow should you have to say to that your job is worth to let go?
Rehearsed, may nakasulat, kaya ka pala punta sa parking, may prepared, the best time to leave your job is now. Joke lang, no. Don't resign, baka meron sa inyo mag-resign. Pero true story to, meron a few years ago na inspire siya masyado, kinamanday yung nag-resign. Mm-hmm. Tapos, yun, 6 months after na ubus lahat ng ipon niya. So, do not resign irresponsibly. Yeah, yeah. Also, paano ako sasabihin? Yung sa akin, you have to make sure also na pag, when you quit your job, yung kung ano yung pinag-quitan mo, meaning either magpo-full-time ka sa stocks, magpo-full-time ka sa business mo, or you will do something else, it's enough already to have a potential to replace your expenses. So, when I say potential, kasi nung nag-resign ako, may times na yung sweldo ko, ganyan, flat eh. Kung ano yung kita mo sa negosyo, sa trabaho mo, flat na yun, forever na yun eh, di ba? Unless may increase, may bonuses, etc. Pero yung anything that's, how do I put this? Anything that's not fixed, anything that's dependent on you and your business and being self-employed or investing, minsan may times na mas mataas sa sweldo mo yun, yung problem doon, minsan mas mababa din siya. Hindi siya fixed. Yeah. So, yun yung trade-off nun. Pero, as long as nakita mo na may potential that it can replace income, nakita mo na may potential that, kasi ito pa nangyayari. Imagine, may mga weeks or months na talo niya yung sweldo mo. Mm. Eh pero, nandun ka 8, 9, 10 hours ka sa trabaho mo. Ah. How much more if you can devote your full time dun sa business? Yeah. How big will it be? How strong will it be? So, yun yung hindi mo pa makikita eh. You will never know until you try it. So, baka iba yung potential niya when you start devoting yourself eh. Kasi hindi lang yung oras yung nawawala eh. Alam mo yun, yung nag-iisip ka sa work, tapos mag-shift, mahirap mag-shift nung isip eh.
Yeah, yeah.
It becomes very, very tiring eh. So yun, the potential for what you're doing to make money, do not resign just because ayaw mo yung trabaho mo.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi, ano siya eh. You resign because when you know you're ready for the next season of your life. Mm-hmm. You resign for something better. You always move forward. You step into a bigger and better season. If you resign just because ayaw mo, that means you're resigning to quit eh. And if there's one thing I know, when you quit, you don't win eh. So, you resign pag sagabal na yung trabaho mo sa business mo. That yun. Next, level of ipon. I think staple doon, you need to at least have 1 year's worth of emergency fund. Then you need to have at least, sa akin na, you need to have several savings also that kung walang pumasok for 1 year, you will be able to function normally. So, yung emergency fund is for emergencies. Yung 1 year na extra is for you to live normally habang wala pang pumapasok na, habang you're trying to adjust to the business. Tapos ginawa ko nun, kinumpit ko. Kunyari, pagka-resign ko, walang pumasok ng pera, how long will I last? So, kumpitin mo, ilan yung savings mo, investments mo, and everything else that you have. Tapos, that's where you see. So, okay, I will last 10 years. Kunyari, walang pumasok. Mm-hmm. Which is impossible, kasi kung masipag ka, may papasok na pera. So, that's how you can sort of make it work.
Yeah.
Next.
Last question.
Oh, last question.
In connection dun sa second question ko, is it worth to leave a job when Is it worth to leave a job when you are earning the same amount of your business profit when you know that your business is unstable and your job is stable?
So, ano to? Personal question or sa'yo to? Or?
General question.
But hindi siya pwede maging general kasi iba, case-to-case basis eh.
Okay.
You have to know kung ano yung potential ng business mo. Kasi if it's earning the same,
mm-hmm.
pero unstable, pero may savings ka naman, tapos it has the potential to earn more,
mm-hmm.
I'll do the job. Pero, depende din. What's your ambition? What do you want? Kung gusto mo maging employee, the extra income lang yung business mo.
Okay.
Pero kung yung business mo, passion mo, it will grow better kahit unstable siya eh. So, yung technique lang dun, in times na maganda yung negosyo, in times that the business is doing well, save ka ng save, hindi mo gagastusin. If you've been watching the previous videos, ito na sinasabi ko ngayon eh. If you want to start doing business, you want to invest, first 5 years of doing it, don't waste money, live simply, put everything back in the business.
Yeah.
So, paano siya magiging unstable if every time you make money, you put it back in the business eh? So, kahit magkaroon ng recession 7 years down the line because you prepared for the first 5 years, okay kayo, and I keep saying this, 5 years of simplicity, hustling, working hard can lead to a lifetime of prosperity.
Yeah.
Kasi yung problema ng ibang nagbi-business is when they make the money, They want to buy the Land Cruiser kagad eh. They want to buy this big house eh. Why not baliktarin mo? When you make a lot of money, put it back in the business, invest it. So when it starts becoming massive, dun ka mag-enjoy. And for me, if you really want to be an employee, di focus on being an employee, side business na lang yun. Pero if you see yourself being an entrepreneur, do it na. Feeling ko yung nagtanong nun, alam naman na niya yung sagot eh. Alam na niya yung sagot, oh, alam na yung sagot eh. Yun. So, what else? Is that it?
That's it.
Do you have more questions?
Masasabi ko lang yung sinabi ni Coach Marvin na the best decision.
Yung may summarize pa!
No, that he made sa buhay niya is yung ano, nag-quit siya sa job niya.
Hindi, napakasalan ko wife ko.
Yun!
Oo, oh, yun yung isa sa pinaka importante kasi anin mo investments kung wala kang love life, wala nagmamahal sa'yo. Di baliwala lahat yun. So I guess that's it. One thing in all of this is that's why you follow your passion, pero you have to remember, as you start following your passion, dapat yung passion na yun, kumikita din. Kasi kung hindi siya kumikita, don't quit your job yet. Kasi no one will pay you if you don't have any skills for that passion. So it's all about developing that skill and that experience as you start following your passion. So that's it. Wala. Yeah. Questions ba? No more? So I hope this video helps you trade well, trade strong, trade smart. Marvin Germo from Doha, Qatar. See you all again soon. Bye-bye.